All right, welcome to the Be the Bridge March. My name is Maya Timberlake, and I am a sophomore on the women's basketball team. Also, one of the organizers of this amazing march. So why did we plan this march? Well, because we wanted to bring the community together to unite against racial injustice and systemic racism. As you look around, no two people are the same. Go ahead, look around. Side. No one looks like you. Hence the name, Be the Bridge. To be a bridge is to connect and appreciate different cultures and perspectives. So, I'm here to introduce our amazing 7 speakers today. These speakers are a part of the Upstate Athletics, Administration, and Spartanburg community. Our first speaker is Antonio Tanner.
Good evening, everybody. I hope you all are doing well. I am Antonio Tanner, as it was mentioned. I am the president of the NAACP here at the University of South Carolina Upstate. Before I begin, I just want to say thank you for everybody that showed up today and showed out. We are the movement. We are not a moment. We must continue this movement, and we must continue to fight what we believe in. This cannot end at today. This must continue when we go out and vote, and this must continue when we enrich our community. In a couple of seconds, we're going to be doing a moment of silence for all the innocent lives lost to the vile acts of police brutality. And during this time, we ask you all to reflect on all the lives that were lost. The lives of Breonna Taylor, Sandra Bland, Tamir Rice, Trayvon Martin, George Floyd, and don't forget Rodney King. Please don't forget Rodney King. If everyone would take a moment right now and just take a moment and think about everything that we've done and what we're going to do, it would be greatly appreciated. Again, thank you everybody for coming out today. And the last thing I want to leave you guys is with, if not us, then who? Have a blessed one, everybody.
Our next speaker is our interim chancellor, Jay Durham Cole Jr.
Thank you, Maya. Thank you, Antonio. And good afternoon, Spartans. What a great turnout. This is so exciting to see you all come together this afternoon. I'm so proud to see this group come together. And I'm proud that you, as students, organized this event. It's because of your passion, your dedication, your sense of right and justice that we are here today. This wasn't organized by administration. This wasn't done through prodding of your professors. You did this, and because of that, I am so proud. Yeah, give yourself a hand. President Barack Obama said, "The best way not to feel hopeless is to get up and do something. Don't wait for good things to happen to you. If you go out and make some good things happen, you will fill the world with hope, and you will fill yourself with hope." Be the bridge. What a theme for today. Leave the toxic rhetoric to the cable TV news shows and Twitter. Many of you have encouraged your friends and classmates to register to vote, and that is fantastic. Now is the time to be informed and go vote. Our republic depends on the participation of informed citizens who exercise their right to cast their ballots. If you don't vote, you have no say in who represents you on school boards, city councils, county councils, state legislatures, Congress, and yes, the presidency. If you don't vote, you let other people make those decisions for you. Primary elections have become increasingly polarized in this country and even in this state, and that's in part due to fewer people voting. That polarization creates a disincentive for your elected officials to work together for the common good. Why does any of this even matter? It seems like politics these days is just a bunch of people yelling at one another, being disrespectful to one another. Who would even want to get involved in that and get in that muck? Well, to answer that in part, I'd like to tell you a story. Some of you know that before I came to Upstate, I was a member of the South Carolina House of Representatives. And I was a member of the House on June 17th, 2015. Does anyone know what is significant about that date in our history? I'll tell you, June 17th, 2015 was the day a self-avowed white supremacist drove to Charleston, attended a Bible study at Mother Emanuel AME Church with 9 black church members and gunned them down because he said he wanted to start a race war. One of those church members was actually its pastor and my former colleague in the state legislature, Senator Clemente Pinckney. He had traveled from Columbia that day to Charleston for the very purpose of conducting that Bible study at his church that evening. Senator Pinckney was known as a bridge builder. In the wake of the killing of Walter Scott by a North Charleston police officer, Senator Pinckney led the fight to require body cameras on all South Carolina police officers, and he was successful in that effort. Following the murder of Senator Pinckney and 8 of his parishioners, the South Carolina legislature overwhelmingly voted to remove the Confederate flag from the state capitol grounds. Senator Pinckney and those 8 other beautiful souls laid the foundation for that bridge to be built to a more unified South Carolina, and in doing so, he built a bridge to me personally. Until the Emanuel 9 tragedy and the conversation about the Confederate flag that followed, I had not thought that much about the presence of the Confederate flag on the state capitol grounds. I had not thought about the angst and pain that my black colleagues probably experienced every day as they walked to work at the Capitol to work for their constituents and the people of South Carolina. And at that point, it only made sense that that flag be removed. Fast forward to today, we only have to look at the senseless and tragic deaths of, to name a few, Jonathan Price, Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and George Floyd, to know we have many more bridges to build to make this country the more perfect union I know we all seek. So be the bridge. Be the bridge to others on campus and in our community. Exercise your constitutional right to vote so you can elect bridge builders who will work not for their reelection campaigns, but for a more just and equitable society for we the people. U2's Bono once said, "This is a time for bold measures. This is our country, and you are the generation. You give us all hope for a brighter tomorrow, and it is an honor for me and my family and USC Upstate to stand with you today. Thank you."
Thank you for speaking today.
Thank you.
Our third speaker today is someone that you probably know well, seen him in the Hodge a couple times, Coach Stacy Palamore.
How's everybody doing today? Good. So I coach, and I've coached at a lot of institutions. This is a great, great event. So you, like the chancellor said, you young people are to be applauded for putting this together. So give yourselves a hand. So as a coach for my 23 years in the business in college, I bring people together. I coach men's basketball, and I coach them from all walks of different life, from different place, different backgrounds, different social paths, the whole deal. And my job as a coach is to bring them together. You know, everybody has a dash. You're born, you dash, and then you die. So my charge to you young people are, what are you gonna do in between your dash? How are you gonna impact other people? How are you gonna make a difference? There's some students here, there's a lot of student athletes here. Don't just be an athlete, okay? This is a huge opportunity for you guys to impact your communities, be leaders on and off campus, and be the bridge for younger people, all right? You're kind of in the middle group. There's a lot of young people that are watching you that are 12, 13, 14 years old. They're watching you as athletes, and they're watching how you behave and the things that you do. My age group, we're kind of set in our ways, okay? We're kind of waiting on retirement so we can just kind of get out of the way. But you young people, this is your time, so you need to take full advantage of that. Be impactful in how you may do that. This is a huge platform. Huge platform. Use it for good. Use it for change. And bring people together for the betterment of everybody. All right? There's a gentleman just passed by the name of John Lewis. One of his favorite quotes was, find good trouble. Find good trouble to get involved in as young people, because you're impactful and people will listen to you. But it's your charge not to just be athletes, but to do great things in the community and society. Your generation is on deck. Make sure that things are done right, in fairness, and for the betterment of everybody. That's huge. Actions speak. So today is a great day. So don't just put this together today and then walk away and say we did it. What are you going to do going forward? That's very important. Voice your intentions, not just words, and don't let this be a one-time deal. This should be an action that creates awareness, change, and unity for all walks of life. Very, very important. Molly's going to come up here in a minute. She's going to talk about voting. The chancellor has talked about voting, okay? You should lock in to what's going on around you. Locally, throughout the state, there's a major race going on right here in the state for the Senate. Pay attention to what's going on. We get locked in sometime to figure out who we're going to vote for president, but the things that impact you directly are the things right here in your local community, and you got to lock into that. Now, I'm going to reflect a little bit. It has impacted me, and I know it has impacted you guys. 2020 has been a hell of a year. Would everybody agree with that? So, with that being said, there's a lot of life lessons that everybody has learned, okay? There's a lot of lives that people have lost. There's a lot of things done wrong to people that is not right. So when you see something, find a good way to be impactful about it and do something about it. Don't take anything for granted. 2020 has taught us that. Don't take anyone for granted. 2020 has taught us that. So as I leave this stage, I'm challenging all of you young people to be the bridge, to go forward and take this day, because we were all enthused about it. Like, we were looking forward to this day. All right, don't just walk away and just go back to your places and let it ride, okay? Band together. If you see something, you see an opportunity to voice your opinion or concerns about something, let's get together and make it happen. You guys are more powerful than you think, all right? There's a lot of people said, just shut up and dribble. No, I'm not going to shut up. I'm going to show you, or you guys should show them how powerful you are. You got that. All right, not just how fast you run or how many times you can shoot threes or dunk. You're powerful people, especially when you come together, okay? Thank you guys so much for your time. You guys have a great day.
Thank you, Coach Palmore, for speaking. Go around for us. Our next speaker is on Black student leaders. He is a marketing chair and on the men's track and field team, Chase Jarvis.
Good afternoon, good evening, everyone. It's great to see everybody's faces out here. Like she said, my name is Christian Chase Jarvis. I am an executive board member for BSL. I am a member of the track and field team, and I am also a member of the Upstate Experience for Black African-American students. The world is changing right before our eyes. Our generation serves as one of the most important generations in today's society as we know it. So I urge you all to make sure that you go out and vote, because it's very important in our society today to make sure you go out and vote. Get involved in what could change our society for the rest of our lives. The ideology of someone being wrong because they don't have the same viewpoints as you is incredibly absurd. What makes America an ideal country is that everyone gets to move as freely as they want to. We speak how we want, we talk how we want, we move how we want. If I put a six down and stand at the top of the six, put you at the bottom of the six, I would say it's a six and you would say it's a nine. That does not mean I am wrong or you are right, even though I did say that I put a six down. It just means we both have different vantage points. We see things a little different. That is constantly what happens in our society. We have different vantage points of each other. The social climate that is currently occurring in today's society right now has tensions growing high between races. People are confused on right from wrong, left from right, and good from bad. The easiest way to make changes in the world is to come together. We are all ants in this society, and it's our job to come together so we can build an empire. This walk is to show us that we are all the same. We all bleed the same, cry the same, and love the same. Today, we are walking to show that Upstate is unified. The name of this march is Be the Bridge. Essentially, what that means is that you must create a walkway to get from one side to the other side. A side that you may be unfamiliar with. If you've ever walked across a high bridge, you know that those first steps are incredibly uncomfortable. However, with anything, you always keep the end goal in mind. Often we begin to grow so comfortable sitting where we are that we refuse to see different sides of different things. When silence consumes a room, it creates a different type of tension between parties because you don't know what's going on in reality. So our job now is to open up, become vulnerable, create new conversations with new people, become more open-minded, become that bridge between friends and have those conversations that make people feel uncomfortable. Change always begins with a conversation. Benjamin Franklin once said, "Change will not happen until those who are unaffected are just as outraged as those who are." Thank you.
Thank you, Chase. Our next speaker is Chief Diversity Officer here at USC Upstate, and his name is Alfonso Atkins, Jr.
Do you all hear me? Thanks. Just in case. So, first off, I'd like to thank you for having me here. I'm so very encouraged by the fact that our student athletes and other students have come together to really celebrate social justice in a way that I think moves me in particular. Most of you have probably heard me wax eloquent about unlawful discrimination here on campus. But you know, so A year ago, at this moment, I lost my dad. And I thought about this all day, that it's interesting I should be here speaking to young people on a day that, quite frankly, I lost somebody who was so very important to me and actually taught me that, if nothing else, you always want to stand your ground. You always want to live in your value. You want to treat people the way in which you'd like to be treated. What I'm so inspired by is that, even though I've been doing this for now 25 years, anytime I get an opportunity to look out and see young people, I have the same thought, not that I used to be one, but quite frankly, I'm energized by you. I'm inspired by each and every one of you. My dad would have been inspired by each and every one of you. It's one of the last things he said before he passed. And it's somewhat difficult, I think. For those of you who may have lost a parent, if you were as close as maybe I was to mine, you probably understand that, you know, it gets better over time. But I don't know, maybe, you know, in my mom's words, you know, there were always little lights of something that could remind you of, you know, someone you've lost as time goes by. You never really, quote unquote, get over it. You always incorporate it into your soul, you know. You incorporate it into who you are. I think I'm just really thankful and grateful that today I get to incorporate you all as a little bit of light into what sometimes can be a really dark moment. But you know that you've probably heard me wax eloquent about our attention as a university to core values, talking about wellness and equity and civility, and undoubtedly they probably just seem like words on a page. But you know, there are demonstrations of that too. What's great is that I see a demonstration of that right now. I mean, right now in this very audience, there are demonstrations of promoting each other's wellness, of minimizing harm, of understanding, quite frankly, that creating the conditions of equity is fundamental to recognizing our humanity. See, that's what civility is about. I think what inspires me the most is that somehow, despite my own cynicism every now and then, there's always something to bring me back, something that actually keeps me going. And you all are such a large part of that. And I really want to thank you for it. You know, our other speakers have actually said some amazing things, and they're all things that I don't doubt many of you have likely heard before. I certainly hope that you take heed to some of the lessons that have been offered. I would never put myself in a position to offer, I think, that much of a lesson. I can only offer my own experience as an example. You know, our first speaker spoke of Rodney King, and when I was a student body president back in college on a football team, I'll never forget that happened. I was on campus, was watching television. I kept seeing this replay of this brother, quite frankly, just getting beat down like there was no tomorrow. And at that moment, I felt as if somehow something was wrong. It's not that I didn't notice it or recognize it beforehand, but you kind of knew wrong when you saw it. I think one of the cool things about social justice is that in many ways, it is just a shared value in which we understand that all of us instinctively can recognize when something is wrong. Every time you hear a group of folks break out into perhaps a chant, right? Understanding the significance and importance of saying, let's say, someone who has passed name, it's because there's a recognition that something is instinctively wrong if we are in a culture that somehow lets go of the sanctity of human life. And we have an opportunity right now, today, in this moment, to use our individual actions as Spartans, administrators, students, guests, to really lean into building the type of community that we aspire. I mean, be the bridge to me, quite frankly, you know, does represent moving from point A to point B. If we can accept specifically where we are now, we understand that all of us can imagine a point B. We can imagine and actually lean into the work that we want to do to achieve that goal. The last thing I'll say, quite frankly, is that there's something special about Be the Bridge. You know, early on in conversations, quite frankly, I heard that theme, and I was, for those of you who don't know, a long, long time ago, right, I was a terrible musician. But in a musical composition, we speak of the bridge. We usually talk about having a verse, right? And then there is a bridge that brings us back to a chorus. I don't know how many of you are musicians or how many of you care about music that much, but one of the things that I enjoy about a bridge is that it allows for an expression, a contrast musically. Each of you, in many ways, you already serve as your own bridges. If we should think that the chorus, perhaps here at USC Upstate and in our community, is one that is born out of love, then hopefully, in the way in which you perform your bridge, we will all work ourselves back into that chorus. I'm inspired by you. I really believe in you, and I love each and every one of you. I want you to know that, because sometimes I feel like we don't tell each other that enough. And on this day, where I am so, so very proud to be Alfonso Atkins Jr., I need you all to know that. Thank you.
Thank you, Al, for spraying the podium too, you know. Our next speaker is a dear friend of mine and is on the women's basketball team, Miss Molly McCutcheon.
Thank you, Maya. Okay, so I know the speakers have hit a little bit on voting. I'm just gonna expand upon it. So this pandemic has revealed a lot about people in government that we may not have noticed otherwise. One thing each and every one of us has the ability to do is vote. We hear every day about what our senators and congresspeople are doing down in Washington, D.C., but how often do we hear about what our state legislature is doing? Compared to Congress, state legislatures are very productive. They pass bills almost every year that affect us differently in each state. The truth is, things that we encounter on a daily basis are decided at the local level. Local elections affect public transportation, taxes that go towards our education, and our local prosecutors who have the final say on who goes to jail and who doesn't. For most of us students, this is our first time being able to vote in a general election. The first step in voting is getting registered. The last day to get registered in South Carolina was October 5th, which has passed. However, the registration deadline is different for each state, so if you haven't registered yet, make sure you still can. Once registered, it is strongly advised that you request your absentee ballot as soon as you can, if you do not plan on voting in person. Some states require things like witness signatures, as well as your own signature, in order for your absentee ballot to be verified. Again, this also varies state to state, so make sure you know what is required for each state. The upcoming general election is November 3rd. It will include voting for our president, our vice president, senator, House of Representatives, and state and local elections, depending on where you're from. We all know that the presidential contest gets a majority of the media's attention. However, state and local elections have a huge impact on our daily lives in ways that we don't even know. Do your research. 2020 has not been an easy year, we all know this. However, this is our opportunity to end it with power. That power is our ability to vote. Thank you.
Okay, and our final speaker to help me in closing remarks is volleyball freshman, Rachel Stroop.
Let's help this up a bit.
Thank you, Maya. As we're leaving here today, I just wanted to remind everyone to not let today just be a moment, but let this be a movement. Continue to have the difficult conversations with your family, your friends, and your peers, and people you don't see eye to eye with. Even if it's not the trending headline on the news or on your Twitter feed, keep the conversation going. It's crucial to keep the conversation alive. Our generation can continue to be the change if we're proactive. With that, we would like to thank Sarah Gildersleeve for making this whole event possible, getting all the everything approved and all the details worked out. Thank you so much, Sarah.
We would also like to thank all of our amazing speakers today. And we would like to thank all of you for coming today. In closing words, don't let this be a moment, but a movement.